Hello there, this is Billy. Today I want to show you how to design and make a crystal radio for the medium wave or AM that can function as both a crystal radio and a regenerative radio that improves selectivity and sensitivity. Before we start, I would like to welcome you to my Billy C DIY channel, where we talk about everything to do with DIY, including crystal radio, hydroponics, some electronics, IoT, and other stuff. If you like this kind of video, please subscribe to my channel. To support my work, you can also visit my Patreon page, where you can become a member. A paid member can download all the 3D print files and other stuff unlimited times. Or you can pay a small amount to download individual projects. Thanks for your support. Now let's go back to the project. I will show you the testing results first, then I will explain the circuit. Finally, I'll show you how I made it. Some of the sounds in the video are very loud, so don't turn your volume too high. Now let's look at the circuit. This is the conventional crystal radio circuit based on the 3DQ, which is a MOSFET. It's a low voltage MOSFET. On the left of the circuit diagram, you can see L1 and L2. L1 and VC forms the resonance circuit. Together, they determine the range of frequency and stations you are going to get from this radio. The hot end, which is the top part of the coil L1, connects to G2, gauge number 2 of the 3DQ. And the cold end connects to G1, gate 1 of the MOSFET. The other input to the 3DQ is the S, the source, where an input signal is put in. And then the D, the drain, is where an output signal will come from. By controlling the signal on the gate, mainly G2, G1 becomes a reference to ground, we can control the flow of current from source to drain. That means how much current flows or not flow between the two. By fitting the amplitude modulated signal to gate 2 from L1, we can control how this current flows, and that becomes the mechanism for detecting, which works differently but similar to how a diode detects an amplitude modulator signal. The output from drain will go through a capacitor, which acts as a low pass filter. High frequency will take the AC path and loop back to the resonance circuit, whereas the lower frequency that is in the audio range is feeding on to the transformer. The transformer ensures that the impedance from the output of drain can be matched with the impedance of the headphone or speaker you choose to use. Usually a 3DQ output impedance is between 1K to 2K depending on the frequency and how strong is the signal. The stronger the signal, the lower impedance it will get. And that the impedance of the headphone ranges between 100 ohm to 20K ohm for a crystal radio. So it can vary a lot. So unless your earbud or headphone matches around 1K, you will need a transformer to do the matching. Otherwise, if impedance doesn't match energy transfer ratio will be much lower. So that means most of the signal will not get to your headphone. It will just be dropped because of the ineffective energy transfer due to the mismatched impedance. In crystal radio, what you are trying to do is to harvest as much energy as possible because there's no power, no amplification. All you can get is try to keep as much energy you can get from the antenna through the coil, through your detector, directly to your headphone. So what we are trying to do here is try to match the impedance to gain efficiency in the energy transfer. For me, I used a very special and very small transformer. It's a 600 ohm to 600 ohm ratio. Then I cross-wire it to become a auto transformer that will adjust the impedance from 1K up to 4K for my crystal earbud. I soldered this tiny transformer at the back of my crystal earbud for convenience. Otherwise, I will need to add the same transformer again and again in every crystal radio that I made. I'll show you how I did it when we come to the how to make it part. There are two ways to modify the circuit a bit to turn this into a regen radio. This is the first one and the simplest one. You just add a battery on the top right. You can see I inserted a 3-volt battery through a switch in between the drain and the transformer. Then I added a variable resistor, VR1, at the bottom of the diagram. And the source drain, instead of directly connecting to L2, will go through that VR. One end of the VR connects to L2, and the other end connects to ground. By adjusting the variable resistor, you can control how much positive feedback goes back to the resonant circuit through L2. In a regen radio, too much positive feedback will turn your radio into an oscillator. That's the whistling sound you heard during the testing. That's why in a regen radio, you need a way to control and adjust the regen level so you can get the best result without hearing the whistling sound. And the VR1 does that job. The second way to turn my radio to a regen radio is to add a third coil called L3. This L3 is wind in an opposite direction than L2. That means if your L2 is wind in clockwise direction, L3 need to be wind in anti-clockwise direction. If you take a look at VR1, the other end of VR1 goes to L3 instead of to the circuit ground. That will allow the VR to choose between having the positive feedback loop L2 versus the negative feedback loop L3. By doing this, you can control the regen level much better. I tested both circuits where we have L3 and the one without L3. I find there's not much difference I can notice. So to make it easier for everyone to make this regen radio, I adopted the first version. That means the one without L3. Feel free to try both circuits. Leave me a comment if you got some different results. This is the circuit that I'm going with. The only difference is at the right-hand side of the diagram where I add a bit more detail about the auto transformer. So I got this 600 ohm to 600 ohm transformer and I cross-wire the output back to the input and create an auto transformer. Auto transformer means there's only one common ground and then you have the output and input all wind on the same big coil. So you can mix and match and create the impedance ratio that you want. In my case, it's a 4:1 or 1:4 ratio. So this diagram is for a piezoelectric earbud. You need a step-up transformer because the impedance of the crystal earbud or piezoelectric earbud is much higher than the 3DQ, around 2 to 4 times higher. The other thing to worry about if you're using a piezoelectric earbud is There's no DC path for a piezo electric earbud because it's a capacitive component. There's no direct connection between the two plates of the earbud. Without a DC path, the two plates that make sounds in a piezoelectric earbud will not be able to release the charges, so it will sound very cracky at times. So you will need to add a 100K or 500K resistor to form that DC path. In a regenerative radio, a earbud with a coil works better. So that's why instead of adding a resistor, you can just use this auto transformer. So it serves two purposes, matching impedance and providing the DC path. If you're using a magnetic earbud or headphone with an impedance of 500 ohm or above, then you won't need a transformer. You just connect your earbud or headphone directly to the 3DQ's output. However, if your earbud or headphone is below 500 ohm, like 100 ohm or even below, then you need a step-down transformer. So in this circuit, I have used the same 600 ohm to 600 ohm audio transformer. We wired in a situation to a step-down transformer and an auto transformer. To make this crystal radio, here are the parts that you need to get. On the top, you got the 3D printed chassis, or you can use your own design for the chassis. This is how the 3D printed chassis looks. In my chassis design, I have holes for the antenna on both the side, the top as well. So you can choose how you want to hook up your antenna. You can hook it up like this or like that. These are the knobs I made, 3D printed. They ensure that they are on the same heights as the different components have different heights. So I dropped the VR a bit lower. Two different type of battery holders for the CR2232 lithium battery. A 1.2 meter long telescopic antenna. It will be useful if you are in a strong reception area and directly using this telescopic antenna to listen to radio. It has an M4 screw for mounting onto the chassis directly. If you don't have a crystal earbud, you can create one easily by using this piezoelectric buzzer. Cut off the tip from your ballpoint pen, or download and print my earbud tip 3D printer profile and stick this to the top of your buzzer. Cut off the two ears at the chassis and use this silicone cushion from your headphone earbud to make it easier and seal the sound so you will hear much better than the conventional crystal earbud. Then connect the tail of the wires to a 3.5 millimeter stereo earphone jack. The DIY earbuds on the left works better than the original crystal earbuds on the right, both in terms of sensitivity and quality. I also got this 500 ohm magnetic earbud. It's a moving iron with a coil inside. It works for 3DQ, but if you work on it directly, impedance doesn't match fully and it's a bit low in volume. You will need a step down transformer for this to work with 3DQ. Here are the different type of transformers that you can buy. This is the 600 ohm to 600 ohm one with a tap at the middle. You can get from Amazon or other places. The quality is okay, but can be better. I'm using this type of Parmalloy transformer. Parmalloy is a scarce metal, so the transformer made have a better permeability and you can wind less coil. So this is the way I hook it up to my back of my crystal earbud. For the coil, you can use a ferret core coil, turret style, or a ferret stick, up to you. And this is the wiring instruction. The ferret core material I used is from a China manufacturer. The material name is R40C1, I will leave a link where you can buy it. But feel free to use the core of your choice, and even using a ferrous stick as well. Just need to make sure the resulting inductance matches up with your capacitance of your VC. Otherwise, you fall outside the AM/MW broadcast range. If you use the 3D printed chassis that are designed for this AM regen radio, you will print out these parts. The cover where you got all the holes to mount the equipment, the parts, and the box. There are different holes here as well, so you can use it to mount the antenna instead of mounting on the front page, instead of mounting on the front panel. These are two knobs. This is the regen knob. This is the variable capacitor. This is the variable capacitor knob. The rest of the video records how I assembled and soldered the parts together. I won't go through it one by one. I'll just skip it in fast forward mode. So before we end, thanks again for watching till now. If you like this type of video, please subscribe to my channel, Billy C DIY. Click like, share with your friends, and leave me a comment. Any encouraging words is also fine to support my work. Also, take a look at my Patreon page. I'll leave a link there where you can find some of the 3D print files and join for membership if you like, so I can provide you more service in the future.